All right, Shalom. Gonna start off by giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Rakak, Wadash. Double honors to our elder apostles and our elders at Great Millstone GMS. Peace and blessings unto the elect. Lord willing, this lesson to be edifying. This the brother Atazaria.
The brother Yakana.
From the GMS Houston camp. And we're gonna start off in the book of Jeremiah, the 7th chapter, at the first verse. So you can read that.
Come. This is Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 1. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, stand in the gate of the Lord's house, and proclaim there this word, and say, hear the word of the Lord, all ye of Judah, that enter in at these gates to worship the Lord. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the power of Israel, amend your ways and your doings, and I will cause you to dwell in this place.
Come. Now, the Most High put it on Jeremiah to tell his people, the Israelites, to amend their ways because we were going off. Now, we had a word amend up on the screen, and this is amend. It says from the early 13th century to free from faults, rectify, all right, correct, set right, make better, improve. From the Latin emendare, to correct, free from fault, okay? Now, I want to get the word rectify also real quick. And this is the word, here we go, rectify. It says to cure, heal, or remedy, okay? It says set straight in conduct or behavior, correct an error, all right? What is the errors? Going off, breaking the law, statutes, and commandments of the Heavenly Father. So to correct them, to amend them, to rectify them, okay? And how do you start by doing that? Could you get St. Matthew 4 and 17? Yeah.
Come. This is Matthew chapter 4, Selagia, verse 17. From that time, Yahawashah began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
And that's what you got to do. You got to be sorrowful for what you're doing. You know, in the majority of our people, they're not sorrowful for the conduct that they engage in. They actually enjoy it, okay? They would prefer to continue in the conversation or the way that they walk in this world, okay, versus amending their ways, rectifying their ways, repenting, okay? Now, when you read the heading of Jeremiah 7 and 1, Selakia, it says, Jeremiah sent to call for true repentance, okay? And this is what the Heavenly Father sent him out to do, to call for Israelites to repent, to be sorrowful for their doings, okay? For going against Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahawashah. So we go back to Jeremiah 7.
Come on. Pick back up at verse 4.
Start it back at 2.
Come on. Jeremiah 7 and 2. Stand in the gate of the Lord's house and proclaim there this word and say, hear the word of the Lord, all ye of Judah that enter in at these gates to worship the Lord. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the power of Israel.
The power of Israel, okay? Because this is only to the Israelites, right? All right? The Lord's people, his portion, okay?
Amend your ways and your doings, and I will cause you to dwell in this place.
Right. Go ahead.
Trust ye not in lying words, saying, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord are these.
Mm-hmm.
For if ye thoroughly amend your ways.
Thoroughly amend your ways. Okay? Don't be playing around. Get right with the Most High. Okay? Like the scriptures say, you know, of course we're going to go off, but the scriptures say offend less. Okay? Right. Go ahead.
For if ye thoroughly amend your ways and your doings, if ye thoroughly execute judgment between a man and his neighbor.
Which our people don't do. Because the way that you judge between a man and his neighbor, which, you know, is by these scriptures, because this word is the standard. This is the law, okay? This is the way that we deal with issues. Like the scriptures say in the New Testament, go to the law, you know? If something is messed up or whatever, you go to the law, okay? You deal with your brother according to this law.
Right.
Okay? Go ahead.
If ye oppress not the stranger, the fatherless, the widow, and shed not innocent blood in this place, neither walk after other gods to your hurt.
Right, and that's exactly what that does. When our people follow these idols and walk after other gods, that's what you're doing it to, okay? Our people are doing it to their own hurt and ultimately their own destruction. This is going to lead to 2/3 of our people being put to debt, okay? Go ahead.
Then will I cause you to dwell in this place, in the land that I gave to your fathers forever and ever.
Right. And and it ultimately, this is going to be the kingdom of heaven, man. Okay? Ultimately, you know, we're going to be placed back in our land. All right? Right now, we're not there. Okay? But if we do what we're supposed to, you know, which the elect in these times, they're going to do this. They're going to amend their ways. They're going to repent. They're going to feel sorrowful. They're going to fear Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai and call upon his name in the name of his son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, to be delivered. Okay? And I mean, that's pretty much it. This was just a quick hit straight to the point. All right?
Come on.
Only the elect is going to do this. All right? Only the elect is going to amend their ways. Only the elect is going to rectify. Okay? Repent and feel sorrowful for their doings and ask the Most High to forgive them. Okay? You had anything?
Nah.
Okay, so Lord willing, this was edifying, and we're going to end it right there. And with that, we're going to say Shalom.
Shalom.